waiting. We have hamburgers, makeup, ice cream sundaes. We're gonna start the line right now. Thank you for your patience. Beauty to the Street started probably a little over 3 years ago. I lost one of my sons. One of my children died back in 1990. He was 5 days to his third birthday. And I have five living kids, so I had six total. And the 30 years that I've been living after his death has just been tumultuous. Like, just a lot of pain. Even though I had five more kids, like, I'm so broken and I could just not get my life together. I kept thinking, like, this pain of the loss of my child was gonna just kill me. It was just like, I'm on Prozac. I came down with panic and anxiety disorder, you know, so I deal with so many emotions and stuff. And so every September, he was born September the 11th and he passed away September 6th. So every September is like my mourning month. Like, I just go into a bubble. I have a twin sister and she's like, okay, you've been doing this for 30 years, Shirley. You cannot live like this. Like, you have five more kids. He wouldn't want you to live like this. And I'm like, but I have so much pain, and like, I could never find a purpose for that level of pain. And through the journey of trying to find something to do with my life, somebody said, you want to come out and feed the homeless with Polly's Project? And I was like, okay. And as soon as I went out to the streets, I was like, oh my God. They're all broken, like, they're just like me. Like, I felt completely at home. Like, I felt like I had a purpose for my pain at that point. So I'm like, oh my God, they're broken just like me. Like, they're troubled. And I just gravitated to them, and I was just serving them food and, you know, clothing with this other organization. And they kept on saying, we love your makeup, we love your hair, we love your earrings. I'm like, you want that? And they were like, yeah. And they started calling me the makeup lady. And I was like, oh, everybody's like, you're the makeup lady. You're the woman who passes out mascara. You're the one who gives eyelashes and earrings. And I'm like, yeah, yeah. And I started taking care of the trans community in the back as well, in the back streets of LA. And yeah, so they were like, people only give us men clothes because, you know. And I'm like, well, you should have what you want to wear. What do you want to wear? They're like, we want women clothes. So I started bringing them wigs and heels and makeup and eyelashes. And that really quickly spread. And when everybody started calling me the makeup lady, I'm like, you know what? Maybe this is something I should do, because it felt like I had a purpose now. Could you use that hair stuff I gave you?
Did I? Well, I can't show you.
No, no. Three wigs per person. But I'm a hood stylist. I know hair and I know makeup. So we call it hood stylist. So I'm a hood stylist.
Mask. Here you go, sir. All right. You. There you go. You got a mask on? I'm telling you, I didn't forget about your loved one. All right.
We got 600 hamburgers from McDonald's today. 600 McDoubles. Double cheeseburgers. So we typically do 600. We try to do one per person, sometimes two per person, depending on the crowd. So today's probably a large crowd. You probably do one per person. Well, I see the media and I see the reports. So it's this angel. I'm not an angel, I'm broken. And broken people recognize broken people. It's like you kindred spirits. Like, they can look at me and tell, like, wow, she is really broken. And I can look at them and tell, and it's kind of like you just organically click.